Good morning, students. It's Saturday. Our SUPW turn is there. And in SUPW, today we are going to start the second unit, which is cleanliness. And the second chapter is cleanliness at home. So cleanliness means that we have to make our surrounding clean. Wherever we are, it's our moral duty. We have to make our surrounding clean. Either we are at home, at school, or on the way. In the park, in the field, we are traveling in any of the vehicle, in train, bus. We should not throw the waste thing anywhere, here and there. Have always throw the waste materials in the dustbin. So here we are going to study about how we have to make our home clean. A clean environment is the key to a good health. It is obvious that if our surrounding is clean, the person become healthy. Otherwise, if the surrounding is dirty, it calls to many kind of diseases. Therefore, it is essential to keep our home and its surrounding clean and tidy. We have to check, not only it's our duty to make our home clean, but nearby area of our house also. We should not have to throw the waste material of our house just outside of the gate of our house or the fencing or the boundary of the house. We have to make our surrounding clean. It means that we have to check the nearby area of our house also. Everyone at home should actively take part in keeping the home clean. Now here again, it is not only the duty of your mother or the maid who is working at your home that they will only clean the home. It is the duty of each and every person of the home to make the home clean. We have to again, what the waste things are there, have to always throw in the dustbin. Cleanliness is the first thing that is noticed when a person enters a room. Here again, if a person is going to enter either in your classroom or at your home, you can imagine when you are going to enter somewhere in the room or in your any of the classroom. If you find that each and everything is kept at a proper place and the floor is also very neat and clean, what's your impression is? You will feel very good. Otherwise, if it is mismanaged, what you will think? That how the person are living here? What the manners they have learned? Nothing is kept at proper place. So it is the first impression of the people who entered in the room. And it tells the behavior also, that how active a person is, how responsible a person is. It is therefore necessary to know the importance of cleanliness. So if there is any doubt, or even anyone is not knowing that how to make the surrounding clean, just have to notice. In a clean house, you will see the following things. What should have to be done? Everything is clean and tidy. There is no sign of dirt. What the things are kept in the room? All things should be clean and tidy, and there should be no dust there on it. The floor is spotless and clean. No spot should be on the floor also. Third thing, things are placed in such a position that they look neat and can be easily picked. What is kept in the room? Everything should be placed at a proper one. As if one wants to get anything easily, he or she is able to pick it from there. Now you students are at home these days. Your duty is to make your home or your room clean. Types of cleaning. There are four types of cleaning. Daily cleaning, weekly cleaning, monthly cleaning, and the yearly cleaning. What we have to do daily to make the home clean. First one, daily cleaning, it involves sweeping and mopping the floor, dusting the furniture, doors and windows to clean the floor. And after that, first clean it with the dry dust and with the mop. A wet mop is used to clean the floor, and then the furnitures and the doors and windows have to be cleaned. Second, weekly cleaning. What we have to do at least once in a week. It involves cleaning of window panes, removing the cobwebs, dusting the pictures, wall hanging, etc. Monthly cleaning. Once in a month, what have to do? It involves grooming and dusting of the ceiling and the walls. Curtains of doors and windows are washed. Things like books, showpieces, etc. are cleaned and rearranged. These things have to be cleaned and rearranged. And then the yearly cleaning. Yearly cleaning involves painting of the house, repairing the damaged or broken parts of the furniture or replacing them with a new one. Painting of the house once in a year, and if anything is broken, so repair it. Either the part of a house or walls or the ceiling or the floor or the broken parts of furniture or replacing them with a new one, which is now it seems that no longer it will be last, so it has to be changed. Some of the things which are required to make the home clean. What they are? Basic tools required for cleaning. A variety of things are required for cleaning a house. Which they are? You all are familiar about these things. These are at your home also. First one is duster to clean the dust. Wiper just to wipe the water from the floor. Mop, it is to clean the floor with water. So a mop is used. Then broom to clean the dust or the dry dust. So broom is used. Then dustbin, and along with the dustpan is there. With the help of it, we can take the dust off the floor and keep it in the dustbin. And the phenol, it is in one of the thing which is used just to in the cleaning purpose. So here we have come to know what things we have to do to clean our house and in what regular intervals we have to clean our house, and what instruments we have to use to clean the house. Next class, we will continue.